Okay, today's sessions will be led by Coach Sasi. Some of you might have known her. Hi, Coach. Coach Sasi, are you here with us? I think she's here with us. Okay. Okay, in 3 minutes, I will lock the room so no one will join us during the conference. I am waiting for Coach Sasi to join us. Hi, Coach, you there? Ah, where is she? And once we start, I hope no one else is typing there for attendance checking. Hi, Coach. Are you there? Where is she? Ah, there she is. Okay, we will start in 2 minutes. And while doing that, okay. So this is how it's going to work. I'm going to navigate Coach Sasi's presentation from here. And later on, please respond to the questions for interactions in the chat room. And for that reason, that is why we expect you not to use the chat room for attendance checking anymore. So please, in 1 minute, we will close it down for the chat room. Okay, I hope it's clear to everyone. Okay, I know that some of you are here and then some just left. Okay, now there are 377 participants. I'm waiting to click on the lock. And please, okay, if you just got in, type in your name now in the chat room after that. Okay, it's 1600. I locked the room. No one else can join. It's 378 participants. Okay, now please clear up the chat room. I mean, stop typing in there. Thank you. Because we will start. Coach Sasi. Okay, I'm going to share her presentations. Coach Sasi, can you hear my voice clearly? Could you please say something? Coach Sasi, please say something so I can hear you. Coach Sasi, we cannot hear you. Everyone, do you hear Coach Sasi's voice?
No.
Okay, now I'm muting again. Okay, while we're waiting for Coach Sasi, I'm going to share my screen and okay, can you see my screen? Now answer this in the chat room. Which part of Indonesia are you from? And please type in your answer in the chat room. please no one write names and student number anymore. Just answer to this question. Which part of Indonesia are you from? Jakarta, Jakarta, Indramayu. Come on, West Java, Riau, Cianjur, Jakarta, Bekasi. Okay, more. Palembang, Bekasi, Bogor, Jakarta, Duri. Okay, Cianjur, Riau, Cirebon, Central Java, Pontianak, Sukabumi, Jogja, Purbalingga. Okay, okay, Tegal. More. Oh, Kalimantan. We have someone from Kalimantan Tengah. Thank you, Singkawang, Central Java. Okay, so I believe that you have your own. Oh, Arema. Arema is from Malang, right? Coach Sasi, can you join us now? We still cannot hear you, unfortunately. Okay, Boris. Where is Boris? Boris in Tangerang? Oh, Jambi. Hi, Jambi. Brebes. Right, now let's move on to the next question. Okay, we move on to the next questions. What do you think about living in Jakarta? I believe many of you have been living in Jakarta, at least during your study time in SDIP. What do you think about living in Jakarta? Right. Okay. Now write about your answer to this second question. What do you think about living in Jakarta? How is it different from your place? From Tegal, from Papua. Oh, so hot. Jakarta never dies. Many pollutions, right? So much mobility. Cool. Pollution everywhere. Boring? Jakarta is boring. Bad traffic. Right. Traffic. Oh, expensive. Yeah, it is expensive. Hot, it's complicated. Busy, many pollution. Enjoy. Okay, so that is what you notice from Jakarta. Okay, so what do you think? Now, this is not in the slide, but what do you think about the people living in Jakarta? Oh, you love Jakarta. Fabulous. Never sleep city, right? So what do you think about the people living in Jakarta? So annoying. Okay, Samuel, so annoying. Barbar, Delina, you sure Barbar is cool? Fake? Nassau, what do you mean by fake? Humble. The people are humble. Okay. Individualist. Selfish. Friendly. Big head. Okay, Jordan. Jakarta's people is friendly. Unexpected. All right. Wonderful. Okay. Thank you for your responses. Coach Sasi, are you with us now? Okay, let me contact her for a while. Individual. It's kind of friendly, yeah? Kosasi, what do you mean, Noval? Kosasi. Okay. Right. But we are not going to talk about this friendliness, arrogant, beautiful city and girl, people of Jakarta. But Coach Sasi has planned to talk about this. Right? About living in multicultural society, that it is an advantage. Coach Sasi, are you with us? Okay. I will lead the discussions while we're waiting for Coach Sasi, okay? Okay. So living in multicultural society is an advantage. before we talk about this multiculturalism, now tell me, what is culture? Type in your answer so I can check your answer. What is culture? Can you still see my screen? Okay. So what is culture? Can you type in your answer? What is culture? Okay, I'm looking at your tradition, characteristic. Thank you. Habit. Thank you. Culture is habit. Okay. Tradition, traditions. Okay, I'm looking at your answer. Oh, more answer. Culture is culture. What do you mean? Culture is a rule, different tradition. So culture is tradition. Okay, you have good answers. Yeah, you have good answers. Thank you. Thank you for your answer. So culture is a set. Wait. Habit of some people. Yeah. Culture is a set of customs, values. Custom is habit, like you said, yeah, right? Values, beliefs, and social behavior of a society. Social behavior also form habits. Heritage, yes, heritage. Correct. Oh, that is a very long answer. Yes, habits, customs, including the values, the beliefs and social behavior of a society. Oh, okay. 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 Wait, all right. Can you see? Now, what is multiculturalism? Type in your answer. What do you think then multiculturalism? Multi and cultural. What do you think it is? Type in the chat. Okay. What do you think multiculturalism is? Multi is many, like it means many. Culture, okay, many to one. Tolerance, many of the cultures, more than one culture in one society, okay. Thank you, Sharifa. Diversity, Dianmas, okay. Okay, tolerance, a blended different culture, right? Ah, okay, I'm back, sorry. Okay. Right. Good. What is okay? More than one culture. Okay. I'm sorry, I cannot respond to raised hands for now. Please don't raise hands. Please don't raise. Okay, so multiculturalism is cultural diversity. Most of you have got the answers correctly. It's cultural diversity coexist, like coexist, existing together. So all of you have got it correct. Right, unity in diversity. That is Bhinneka Tunggal Ika, right? Now, you, what does it feel like living in the dorm? Like, I know you live in the dormitory, at least in STIP, with people from different cultural background. What does it feel like? Can you type in your answers in the chat room? And please stop raising your hands. Maybe you did it accidentally. It's moving. Okay. What does it feel like living in the dorm? Wait, I need to access one. Okay. Yep. Okay. 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 Right. Thank you. You've been actively participating. Okay. Right. Now let's move on. Okay. I believe you have experience in developing multicultural competence because you have been there. You lived in multicultural society. Like it's a normal condition and situations all across Indonesia, especially in Jakarta. At least for this last 2 years, you experienced multicultural society in Jakarta, even at school in STIP. So how to develop it? Theoretically speaking, multicultural competence is the ability of individuals like you, like me, and the systems to respond respectfully and effectively to people of all cultures, classes, races, ethnic backgrounds, sexual orientations, this is debatable till now, faiths or religion, in a manner that recognizes, affirms, and values the worth of individuals, people, families, tribes, communities, and protects and preserves the dignity of each mentions communities. So how do we develop this? The first one is we have to value diversity. I believe every one of you value diversity. Some of you even mentions unity in diversity. Okay, so we consciously fully aware that we educate ourselves about diverse cultures, learning other cultures, understanding tolerance, like many of you also mentioned something about tolerance in daily interactions, which you are so trained about it, at least at school. And then the second one is modeling an attitude of respect for diverse cultures. we treat diverse individuals with respect. So it doesn't matter if the skin color is different, the tongue is different. Sometimes people laugh at your accents. Yeah, I noticed that in classes. I know you sometimes you do it for fun, not to mock, but you never know what's happening inside of a person's mind. Someone can get offended by what you are laughing at because it's what they have. That's part of their culture. And then the third one is that we need to be aware of the diversity which exists in our community. In this sense, in STIP, for example, and in a broader sense, all across the world. Understand and appreciate the diversity that is around us. Like, imagine if everything is the same color, everything is in the same shape, it will be a boring life. Don't you think so? Now answer in the chat room, like, do you think it is better to have a monoculture community or a multiculture community? You can type in which one, monoculture or multiculture. Okay. Wow, thank you. Okay, our time is running. So, and then the fourth one, understanding different, but somehow we are similar. Yeah, we have differences, but as human beings, we are also similar in taking appreciation and hoping for acceptance. Like, I believe that all of you would want to be accepted as you are. If you come from your place, for example, from Riau or from Kalimantan or from Papua, you come to Jakarta and then everyone here expects you to be or to act like Jakartans, I don't think it will be, you will feel comfortable about not being accepted as who you are. So in that sense, everyone is similar. Like, we are we want to be appreciated, we want to be accepted as who we are, not to change ourselves for something the same for everyone. Like, I cannot imagine if everyone is expected me to act like a Japanese, for example, because I live in a Java island. It's not who I am, something like that. Okay, and then the number five, providing activities, like in actions, integrate aspects of different cultures into all of your activities. Most activities lend themselves to a multicultural approach. Social events, sports, street fairs, like these things we did at school in STIP. Activities not exclusively for a certain kind of group of cultural background, but we always have mixtures of people from different places, right? Okay. Now, this is your next questions to answer in the chat room. What do you think is the most challenging aspect of working or studying? Now you are studying in a diverse environment. Can you type in the chat? Ooh, I've got so many chats. Oh, okay. Okay, I think there are so many of you that my internet broke. Okay. The atmosphere, being tolerant, language, how is it an issue? Know each other. Okay, Language, 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 language. Okay. Can you tell me how is it the most challenging part? How is language the most challenging issue? What language are we talking about? Language and mindset. Culture, which part of culture? Can you be more specific about it? Language again. Yeah, can you be more specific about which part of culture? To understanding other ugly habits. Yes. Sometimes we think that habit is strange or unusual or disgusting, but it's their culture. We cannot laugh about it. But sometimes it does happen. Like I'm not going to say an example, but there are some habits of people that to us it looks unacceptable, disgusting, or ugly, as you said, but it's just it is. Okay. STIP is a diverse environment. Okay, I have one question about STIP. Who misses coming back to school, to STIP? Who missed coming back to STIP after 2 months? Not so many of you missing coming back to school. No, I don't believe you. Like it takes you so long to think about it, whether I miss school or not. You enjoyed home so much now. 2 months and counting, like you're coming back to school at least, or June is the soonest, I think. Okay, now we move on. All right. Why is living in multicultural society good for us? Why living in multicultural dorm is good for you and also for me? First is adaptability. Like if you work later on, nothing will surprise you anymore about this diversity because you are accustomed to it. You are familiar with the situations. And then open-minded. Like you have a lot of references about people from different backgrounds. Nothing surprises you anymore. And then the third one is supportive environment. Living in a single belief system, if you live in a monocultural society, you have one belief only because it's part of the culture. That would mean that doing anything different would go against the system. You don't have any choice because you have only one. If you are facing like differences, you have options. You can choose which one you think fits you better. But if it is only one, that's what you have. No option, no choice. Professional, like it is a test. Employees coming from various cultures can contribute with a wider range of perspectives on an assignment because a mix of cultural experiences helps in problem solving and it can create a strong team. If taken care of very well, then it can create a strong team. Unless you cannot handle it, it will be an issue. And then multinational companies, like this is an opportunity that you have more abilities or more opportunities to serve or to work in a multinational companies because multinational companies will have diversity at all aspects. Now these are the generic tips to survive in multicultural society. I'm not going to talk this to you because you experience it better. What is your tips? Like these are the tips theoretically speaking, do not expect open-mindedness, respect the other community, not just your community, read and prepare, and be sure before adopting a certain culture. Now, what is your tips? Can you type in your tips? I will be looking at your tips. Okay, what is your tips to survive? For example, in diversity in STIP. Stay safe and stay home. What is that? Okay. What is your tips? Stay at home? No. What is your tips to survive STIP in a sense of that diversity? If you come from different parts of Indonesia, except Jakarta and the surrounding, looking at your answers, I'm waiting. Respect, patience, tolerance. Okay, good. Respect. Trust. That's a good thing. Trust. Be kind. That's also very good, Olivia. Flexible. Be flexible. Okay, not too stiff and idle in performance. Flexible. Okay, Angga. Don't be selfish. Thank you, Vera. Be friendly. Thank you, Petra. Okay. Can I have more answers? Where? Open-minded. Respect. Okay, thank you. Humble. $5. What is it, Nassau? $5. Don't be egoist. Egoist is like selfish, Rizky. Respect, mutual respect. Siva says, confidence, thank you. Just like a water, what does it mean, like a water? Like water, you mean? Okay. Ah, okay. Okay. Healthy life and stay motivated? In relations to multiculturalism, like diversity, confidence, nice, confidence from iPhone. Who is this iPhone? Okay, thank you for your responses. Okay, we are at the last page. So for conclusion, a multicultural society is a rich society, of course, with all the diversity. It makes one successful society if united fairly. So now your task is to write 80 to 150 word paper about your experience in multicultural society. It can be at school, at home, communities, or anywhere. Submit it to your SIS course Google Classroom. I will provide later on, I will provide the platform where you can submit your paper. And I'm so sorry that Coach Sasi couldn't make it to join us here, some technical issues. Thank you. Nothing lasts forever. We can change the future. Sure you can. Okay. Now I will unmute you, and then I mute you. If anyone wants to say something, please unmute yourself. Can you unmute yourself now? So I won't have to do it all. Can you unmute it? What do you like? What is okay? Okay. If you have questions, please type in your questions in the chat room, or you can unmute yourself. Can you unmute yourself? You can't. Okay, so is the homework clear? It's due today. So the reflection paper due today. Again, I will repeat, write 80 to 150 words of paper reflecting on your experience living in a multicultural society, like at school, at home, communities. Maybe you have bike communities or scouts, pramuka, the anak pramuka, maybe, or karang taruna. I don't know. You can reflect on that.